In this video, I will show you the main features of Anavasi mapp mobile application. First, let's install the app from the Play Store. Look for Anavasi, then tap on the title and then on Install. The installation needs, of course, connection to the internet, and the size is about 6 megabytes. After installing the app, we can launch it by tapping Open. The app gives access to some free maps that will allow you to test the app features before purchasing a map. Also, before downloading your first map, you need to give the app some permissions that will allow it to function. So if I tap on the first map, before downloading it, the app will ask for the following permissions. The first one is the access to my location. This will allow the app to display my location on the map. The second one is access to files. This will allow the app to attach photos from your gallery to the waypoints you create. And the third one is access to the camera that will allow you to take photos to also attach them to the waypoints you create. After giving these permissions, we can now download the first map on the list to test the app. The download speed will depend on your connection speed to the internet. And of course, we suggest you do this when you are on Wi-Fi and not on mobile data. When the app is downloaded, it is automatically opened and centered on that map. Let's now see how we can purchase a map. We go back to the main screen by tapping the back button, and then we go on the bottom right to the store. Here you can browse the map list or search for a map. Let's, for instance, search for the map of Karpathos. As you can see, as soon as I tap the first three letters, the only map I see is Karpathos. Now, to purchase the map, I just need to tap anywhere on this entry. This will start the purchasing process that is managed by Google Play. So here I can see the product I'm about to buy, the means of payment, in this case a Visa credit card, and on the bottom I have the one tap buy button that I will now click. After the payment is successful, the map is automatically added to my maps list. It's then automatically downloaded and opened. Let's now see the other features of the app. On the bottom right hand of the map, we have two buttons. The first will hide the Anavasi map and will show you a satellite image background. If you tap on this button again, it will show the map again. Below, we have the recenter button that will only work when you are within the map's boundaries. If you are not within these boundaries, you will see the message that is displayed on the bottom part. On the bottom, we have four other buttons. The first will allow you to add a waypoint. First, you need to center to the point you want to add the waypoint, then tap on this button, then tap on the label, then give it a title, for example, test, and a description, test again, and then tap on add marker. If you want to see the list of the markers you've added, you have to tap on the second button on the bottom bar. This will open the list. From here, you can hide and show the markers like so, delete them with a bin, or edit them with a pencil. To validate the action you want to do, you have to press on the top right button with a V. The third button is the list of routes in the area. So if you want to activate some of these routes to show them on the map, you select them like so, and then tap on the top right button. As I zoom out, you will see that these routes are now displayed on the map, and by tapping on these routes, we can see their title and length. Lastly, the fourth button on the bottom right is the key to the map, which you can zoom just like the map to read it more easily.